Welcome. In today's testing tutorial, I'll be teaching database testing using NightwatchJS, which has become my preferred automation framework over Selenium. If you aren't familiar with NightwatchJS yet, you can learn more about it by subscribing to my channel, where I have more testing tutorials and NightWatch test case examples. Likes and comments keep me motivated and are always appreciated. So first, let's talk about when it's appropriate to use SQL database assertions in your browser-based automated tests. A common reason or use case would be when there is nothing in the front end to check to validate a passing outcome in your test case. For example, submitting a form may store a value that is not observable in another web page, and in this case, you'd have to check the database to ensure working functionality. So that being said, you should consider if this scenario may be a better candidate for a lower-level integration test instead of using a browser-based system test. You may find that tests used for validating that your code inserts the expected values in the database work better as integration tests. However, you may be forced to use system testing if the logic you're trying to test is coded into the view. You may run into this, especially when testing legacy applications written before the MVC type sort of patterns. And another use of database testing in browser test automation is to reduce the amount of UI navigation in your test cases. For example, a new user registration test case might involve completing a registration form and then signing in as the user and verifying that the user's information is displayed on some other page. With a database assertion, you could skip all the steps after registration is completed and assert the new user row directly in the database. Database checks would be faster and more reliable than dealing with the front-end UI and less likely to change. Now let's cover how to write automated database tests using NightwatchJS. In MySQL database tests, I typically check if the row count equals an expectation against a where clause. To support doing this in NightWatch, I'm going to use a custom NightWatch assertion using an NPM package called NightWatch MSSQL assertions. This package will allow me to connect to a Microsoft SQL database and assert against an expected row count matching my supplied where clause. So now let's go over setting up the NightWatch test project for database tests. So to start us off, we're going to head over to my GitHub. That's at github.com/reallymellow. And all the examples for these NightWatch tutorials are in the NightWatch tutorials directory. So we're going to go ahead and clone that. All right, so now let's head inside database example. So that you don't have to be running Microsoft SQL on your home computer, I've included a Docker file here. And inside it, we're going to be creating a database called NightwatchDB that holds a table of people. Those people are John Doe, Jane Doe, and Really Mellow. And that's going to allow us to write some more interesting test cases later. Let's back one out and go over to the test app directory. This is an Express server that's going to allow us to insert some records into that database. So we have an add person and a remove person endpoint that we're going to be using in our tests. And lastly, we have the test directory where all of our tests will be hosted. All right, so the first thing we need to do is build our Docker container. So inside our NightWatch tutorials directory, let's switch over to the database examples folder. And then inside there, we can run docker image build dash dash tag NightWatch SQL DB colon one period. And that'll go ahead and build that Docker image for us. And now we can run that image using Docker container run on port 1433. And we're going to remove it when we're done using the rm command. We're going to say the name is NightWatch SQL container. And we're going to say to use NightWatch SQL DB1 as our image. All right, so now we have our pre-seeded Microsoft SQL database running on the computer to use later. So we'll just go ahead and minimize that and leave that running. Now that we have our database running, let's go over to the test app directory and open a command line there. And this is an Express server, so we're going to run npm install. And that's going to bring in all the npm package dependencies. Now we can launch the Express server using node server.js. So this server is now running on your localhost on port 8080 and connecting to that Docker container containing our Microsoft SQL database. And we can see that by going to localhost 8080, and you should see a nice hi there message, which means we are ready to now write some tests. So now let's go back to the root of the NightWatch tutorials directory and open up database examples, and using your favorite IDE, we can go ahead and take a peek in here. So on the left side, you can see our file tree. Let's talk first about NightWatch.json, and this is the config file that NightWatch uses to run itself. So the source folders is where NightWatch will look for all of its tests. The globals path can contain any kind of global sort of setup or teardown logic you want to write in your tests. As I mentioned at the top of the video, to give us the capability to write database assertions, we're going to be using NightWatch's custom assertions capability, and you specify that in the custom assertions path. It takes an array of any of the custom assertions logic. The NightWatch MSSQL assertions get brought over in the package JSON that I've specified down here in NightWatch MSSQL assertions. So inside here, you just give it the path to the node modules NightWatch MSSQL assertions source assertions folder, which is where the source code gets downloaded to. And the rest of these settings here allow you to configure your Selenium WebDriver processes, but let's get down into what we need for this test more specifically. So inside the test settings folder, we have a globals section, and this is where this NightWatch MSSQL assertions library is going to know how to connect to your database. So this is where you would specify the database username, password, address, port, and DB name. So we're just going to use the SA username. This is the password that is already set on the Docker container that we're running. It's running on localhost on the port 1433, and the database that we're going to be using is NightWatchDB. So now to bring in the rest of our packages, we're just going to open up another PowerShell window and do npm install inside the root database example directory. And that brings all our dependencies in, such as the MSSQL assertions. So for our first test case, let's verify that there's only one Jane Doe in the database. So let's name that verify only one Jane Doe. And that takes the browser object. And so all we need to do now is say browser.assert record count is, and then we put our expected record count so that we're going to say one. And that is in the people database. And then we need to give it our where clause. So we're going to say first name equals Jane and last name equals Doe. So now all we need to do to run this is open up our command prompt and type in NightWatch. It's going to go ahead and launch that browser object, and you can see it connecting now. Verify only one Jane Doe, and the test passed. A nice output here. It shows your where clause and that it should equal one. So now we can write a more interesting test case, maybe something to verify all the records in the database, just as another example. So verify only three records exist. Same thing, function browser. So we can say browser.assert.recordCount is, and we're going to say three on the people database. And I just wanted to show this one because I wanted to prove that you can omit the where clause, and that's just going to return all the records in the database, which might be useful for some other test cases that you want to write. So now let's go back and run that again. Okay, so there's still only one Jane Doe, and testing if the record count equals three, and there we go. We've got our three assertions passed. All right, so admittedly, those are some pretty simple test cases. So now let's do one that's a little bit more involved that would actually simulate what you would be doing in the real world. So to save time, I've just pasted this test case here called verify John Wick count. And that has two URLs. One is for adding a person and another one is for removing a person. That person is John Wick in this case, and also the where clause for finding John Wick. Now for the actual test execution, I have a bunch of chained calls here, so let's dig into this. So at first we're going to assert that the record count is zero because there should not be any John Wicks in the database to start. We're going to use the NightWatch URL property to navigate to the Add John Wick webpage. Here I'm verifying that the body of that webpage contains the text Added John Wick. And then we're going to go there twice more to make sure that we get three total records added for him. And then we're going to go once to the remove John Wick URL, and we're going to verify again that the text on the web page this time says removed John Wick. And we'll pretend that the functional specification for remove John Wick hunts down and removes all John Wicks from the database. So we're checking that there should be no more people left over with that name on that last assertion. And just to verify that no other database records were touched, we're going to verify that our friend Jane Doe is still in the database and that only John Wick was removed. So now let's go ahead and save this and rerun our test case. You can see it's going to go very fast in a moment. All right. So as you can see here in the test output, we have our first assertion to verify that we start off with zero John Wicks, and then we add up to three. And then when we remove John Wick, we're back down to zero, and then Jane Doe still exists. And lastly here, since we're testing against the database, we need to ensure that the tests clean up after themselves or subsequent test runs might start to fail. So to do that, we're going to leverage the after each test hook inside NightWatch, which I'll paste here now. And inside here, we're just calling the browser.url to the reset endpoint. And I've seen other ways of doing this, like restoring database snapshots and things like that, or you can write some sort of custom delete. But in my case, I just have a reset endpoint that resets the database back to the preceded data that came with the Docker image so that between tests, we're all set to go. So again, I'll just show you the test run again. And just to prove that it works twice in a row, I'll run that once more. All right, so there you have it, writing database assertions in NightWatch.js. I hope you find that this helps you in your testing at work. And as always, I hope you found this tutorial helpful. And if you did, please click on the like button down below and consider subscribing to my channel for future testing videos. Thanks for watching.